right. So did we get to see your relationship progress with the two of you, or are you guys, how does that work? Because I know you guys are like not on again, off again, but
we're working on again. We got to start with on again before we go off again.
Yeah.
One of the joys of playing this character is something that I really identify with, is feeling lost in the world of love and romance, which I think is something that a lot of people identify with, and I think it's something the fans are identifying with. So I do think there is something genuine between Tappy, between Toby and Happy. But it's Quintus, not Tappy. But it won't come easy.
Hashtag Tappy.
Yeah, that's it. You're the new Bradgelina. That's
there
it right there.
There was an online poll between Tappy and Quintus, and Quintus went out. So our official name is Quintus.
Quintus. Okay. All right.
I like that, you know, besides your relationship, I like that everybody has such a unique relationship with each other. And is that explored more now as you get into season two, where we see everything kind of fleshed out even more?
Yeah, I mean, I think that for me, like, last season, when they started to pair, like, even Happy and Kate, and that was just a new dynamic, and I was like, oh, we've never really gone out together, like, and it would just kind of stir up the questions. And I feel like this year, there's a lot of room just for, again, for the relationship to get deeper, and the dynamics to, like, there's just more room to play with.
How much of the technical stuff do you guys read? Are you just repeating what you're reading off the script?
Yes.
Or?
Yeah. It's a high volume of words that you're being ordered to say, so do our best to learn what we can, but it's a very intense job. We shoot a lot every day, all day, so I do my best to learn what I can. Even when I learn it, it lasts for a few hours, not an hour. But when we're shooting it, I usually know about it. And if we don't, we always have a writer on set today.
And that technical stuff, learning that so you can repeat it, is that a lot more? You spend a lot more time on that specific parts of the script than the other parts?
You know, something we all learned and we spoke about a lot on set is doing a show like this is a marathon. It's not a sprint. And I don't think you can approach the show like you would if you were doing the Scorpion movie. So when it comes to learning about the genius stuff or the character stuff or exploring a certain aspect of the show, we do what we can. And it's a group effort with the writers, the producers, and us. So sometimes we just have to trust that it's going to be there. And when we have a chance to learn about something, we'll do that. When we have a chance to explore it, we'll do it. But if there's just not enough time to get lost in it. And I think our writers are good enough that we do it. And when it's time to focus on another thing, we will. But sometimes it's just about trust.
Is there something in season one that you really liked or touched on that you hope they go back to as the seasons progress? Or?
Well, somebody asked, like, just the whole relationship with Happy and her father. But again, like, I go back to, like, the characters. Like, I feel like every week we have a case. And these geniuses, they know how to do this. You know, they'll come across, like, obstacles, but they know how to solve them. And it's in the relationships where there's, like, that's the conflict. That's where they have no idea. They don't know how to solve it. And so I think that's the thing that I'm excited to sort of continue to explore.
I love the relationship, too, that everybody has with Ralph. Like, that kid just brings out something in everybody.
Yeah, the show, what the fans are responding to are the characters and the intermingling of it. And the fans love Ralph. So we're going to continue to go down that road. And as actors, us getting more comfortable in it means we just get to rhythm. So it's a real blessing to be at season two, where we're not just trying to get it right. We're just going to go.
Is your relationship what people like talk to you about most, or is there one thing that people say to you like, oh, I
the Toby Happy
this?
Thing?
Yeah.
Yeah, that really, people respond to that, and people root for it. I mean, I think people like the mysteries and they like the action of it, but the thing that they're really interested in are the interactions between the characters, which is so great as an actor. You know, that you get to do all the action. Really, the heart of the show are these people.
Do you do a lot of your own stuff? Because there's been a lot of action. Do you guys get to get in there and do it, or do you have like doubles that do like really significant stuff?
I have a really great stunt. Her name's Lauren, and I think after the first season, I was like just so appreciative and also had a new respect for what they do, because it is tough, you know, and I go in when I need to and do the things that I can, but she does all the, like, you know, going underneath the SUV on a skateboard, like, she does that, so, I do what I can, but it's mostly her.
Shooting the show in of itself is a stunt, is a production, it's a lot of work, and it's very taxing on physically, mentally. So we don't jump off a building, but we do show up at work and get it done every day.
Is there something?
Oh, no, no.
I was just gonna say, is there something that you guys really want to see? You know, together?
I love these guys facing their emotional fears. You know, I think we come up against physical limitations every week. But I really enjoy, especially Toby and Happy, challenging each other. The first sneak peek of it last year was when there was an episode where we went to Bosnia, and I was calling her out for being closed off emotionally, and then she called me right back out. And as an actor, I get comfortable in the character, and there's kind of things that I fall back on, but then I get her character then calling me out for it. So it's fun to not be allowed to get lazy in that and do things emotionally that we haven't done before.
Something I liked about that episode is that that's really not a conversation to have when you come to it. You know? And I love the fact that it comes up when that should be furthest from the mind at the moment.
And our producers do a great job of making that feasible. You know? It sounds insane, but now let's have a relationship call. Bosnian rebels are chasing us. So what about us? Do you want to go on a date? You know? And it's ridiculous and it's fun, but that's what makes Scorpion unique. And when you watch the show, it works. I don't know how they make it work, but they make it work.
Well, wasn't that a date?
That was the ultimate date, yeah.
According to Toby.
Yes, exactly. Never a dull moment.
Oh, I was just wondering if there was a time jump. When you guys come back, are you coming back almost immediately after where Walter's in the hospital, or are you, like, jumping ahead 6 months, or...?
Fiction's matching reality. I think it's a few weeks. Just as long as we were away from shooting, the characters were away from the garage. So it's fun as actors, because on our first day, we were like, oh my god, what are you even up to? And our dialogue matched our real conversation.
Nice. Okay.
Thanks, guys.
Great. Bye. Thanks.